Thank you for having me, and thank you for flying me in to the Pachacucha organizers here in Copenhagen. It's my first time here, and I'm going to tell you about two projects. It's always on the border of reality and fiction, and I think a lot about the idea of social sculpting. So I would suggest we start with the first image. It's also the climate conference at this moment, and this is actually a diagram, a German diagram of the oil reserves worldwide. Now, a lot of people say we have 50 years or 20 years or 30 years or maybe 40 years until we reach for the peak of the oil reserves. I think it's about time to act. And that's why I discovered an oil field in the middle of Berlin, which is called Spreefeld. It's actually here, it's Alexanderplatz, whereas there's A, it stands for Alexanderplatz. It's a very small oil field. I've been talking to scientists, and it's normally too small to drill and make a test drill, but we've decided, because it's about time, that every city becomes self-sustainable in energy resources. We decided to give it a go. With two friends, we started drilling in the Mauerpark. There's an oil drilling installation. We did quite some research, and it was really dirty work. You know, like what they say about Berlin, that it's poor and sexy. So if we could make Berlin self-sustainable, it could become rich and sexy. And of course, a lot of people, you know, could have jobs, and we could have some kind of like Las Vegas kind of Berlin style trash, sexy and rich. So it took us a couple of weeks, actually 2 weeks, to drill like up to 2 kilometers. Because it's a small oil field, it's not very deep, but still it's 2 kilometers down drilling, and we were successful. So I'm a rich man by now. This was an amazing moment. This was the first time the oil came out, and because nobody actually believed that. There was television crews calling me, is this really true, is it not true? And I said, yes, it's a very small oil field, but it's really worth drilling the oil. So, but to be honest, it's of course a cynical statement against global energy policy, because it's a doomsday scenario. Maybe one day oil is getting, you know, like we don't have enough oil, everybody's digging for the last drip of oil, and we start digging in big cities. And actually, the best place to drill oil, we found out, is under the Neue National Gallery of Mies van der Rohe. So we talked to the mayor, and it's going to be torn down, and we're going to dig for oil. Next project. There's a book called The Cold Equator by Enki Bilal. And I've known this comic since I was 19. And in this comic, you see people boxing and playing chess. I started boxing when I was 25. I always wanted to start boxing, but my mother didn't allow me. And at a certain point, I met a friend of mine. This is, by the way, this is Enki Bilal, and that's Antoine Lecon. It's a comic comedian from Paris. They flew to Berlin to make a TV show about chess boxing for Canal Plus. I once met my friend. I used to play chess with him in a bar, and then we started boxing 2 years before. And then I came up, okay, let's do a chess boxing fight. Which basically works like this. This is the World Championship in Berlin in 2008. It's a round of chess which consists of 4 minutes. The board goes out of the ring, you put on your boxing gloves, and you box for 3 minutes. It's 11 rounds of total, 6 rounds of chess, 5 rounds of boxing. You win by checkmate, knockout, or exceeding the chess time limit. I know this is difficult to understand because you saw I was drilling for oil, and now I tell you something about brawn and brain sport. But this is actually an English guy called Andrew the Rock Costello. He's a free fighter and a very good chess player. And the other guy is an Italian. He has a doctor title in biology, a professional boxer, and a very good chess player. We set it up an organization, the World Chess Boxing Organization. There are now 4 organizations, the WCBO, the Great Britain Chess Boxing Organization, the German Chess Boxing Organization, and the Siberian Chess Boxing Organization. This is Nikolai Sashin. He's a math student. At that time, he was 19 years old. He studies at the University of Space Science. He's an amateur boxer. He has more than 90 fights, of which he won 90%. And he's a very good chess player. He went 70 years to a chess club called Ladia, which in Russian means the knight, which is a chess piece. This is his opponent, 17-year-old Leonid Chernobyl from the city of Gomel, which is a white Russian city close to Chernobyl. He's a very good chess player. He used to play a lot of chess Olympiads. His ELO rating, his chess rating is 1,997. And he went to the junior European boxing championships like 4 weeks, 4 months ago and became fifth. This is the poster in Krasnoyarsk. It was 2 weeks ago. I visited the world championship in chess boxing in the light heavyweight division. It's Leo Granit Kraft, we turned him into a German, fighting the Siberian guy, Nikolai the chairman Sashin. This is the arena. Krasnoyarsk is only 23 drives with the train from Novosibirsk. And in front of 2,000 people, these highly trained people, sports people, very young in both disciplines, fought against each other over 11 rounds. Now, chess boxing has been here since 2002, but I've never seen such a high quality sports event. I mean, I'm actually a performance artist, and I started this as an art performance, but we always wanted to make it into a real sport. And I think by now, with this fight, by these two talented, very talented sportsmen in both disciplines, I think we reached for the goal that it turned into a real sport. Nobody thought about art or whatsoever watching this game, neither did the people who were in the ring. So this is Nikolai Sashin throwing a really nice left jab to the face of Leo Granit Kraft, who was actually very strong in the boxing, but of course he's 17 and the other guy, Nikolai, was 19. At the end, he actually won in the chess by playing the endgame, a queen against a rook, and he won it. He checkmated Nikolai Sashin in the ninth round, which is a chess round. Behind me, behind Leo, that's me, and that's the world championship belt for the chess boxing light heavyweight division. Thank you very much.